So now we want to find out what is the displacement during time t is equal to 6 and t is equal to 10 seconds. Okay, so during this time interval 6 to 10 seconds, what is the displacement of that particle? So displacement has equation change in the position. So final position minus initial position. So here final time is 10 seconds and initial time is 6 seconds. So it is x 10 minus x 6. This is the displacement. So this is equal to x 10 value, that is equal to 48, and x 6 is also 48. Okay, that means net displacement, it is 0. So x 10 is 48 minus 48, so displacement is 0 meter. And also we have to find out the total distance traveled. So to find out the total distance traveled, refer the position of the particle with respect to time. So when x is equal to 0, t is equal to 0, initial position is 16 meter. Okay. So you can draw these points on the x-axis. So this is the initial position. Suppose we have the origin somewhere here. So this is the 0. So this is x is equal to 0, that is origin. Then this is 16 meter. When t is equal to 0. X is equal to 16 meter. Okay. Then at t is equal to 2, we have x is equal to 20 meter. So particle motion starts from this point. So this is the starting point. Okay. And particle is moving along the straight line in this direction. So initially it is at 16, then it reaches 20. After that, it reaches 32, then 48. So after 48, particle is at 56. And after 56, again particle travels in the negative direction. Okay, and it again comes to the point x is equal to 48. So total distance traveled means actual path traced by that particle. Okay, so particle will travel in this direction up to time t is equal to 8 seconds. Okay, and after t is equal to 8 seconds, it reverses the direction and it travels towards the point x is equal to 48. So this is from 8 to 10 seconds. Okay, so this total path traced by the particle, we have to add this from 16 to 56. So this distance will be 56 minus 16, that is equal to 40. And then we have to add this 56 minus 48. So this is equal to 8 meter. Okay. So this path from point A to B, this is equal to 40 meter, and from B to C, this is equal to 8 meter. total distance traveled, this is equal to 48 meter. Okay, so refer this problem. A car starts from the rest and travels along a straight track. Its motion is shown by using the AT diagram, that is acceleration time. And from this, we have to find out the velocity time and the position time graph. And also we have to determine the time T needed to stop the car. Okay. So at this time, which is the unknown time T, we know the condition for the car's velocity. So at time T, the velocity of the car, so Vt, this is equal to zero. Okay, because the last sentence shows that time T needed to stop the car. Okay, that means at this point, velocity of the car will be zero. So this is the final condition. Okay. So by using this condition, we can find out the corresponding time. So from acceleration time graph, if you want to find out the velocity time graph, okay, then we will use this equation. Vf is equal to Vi plus area under the AT diagram from time Ti to Tf. Okay. So the time we will take as a V10. Initial velocity will be V0 plus area under the AT diagram from time 0 to 10 seconds. Okay. So to find out V0, refer the given problem. The first line, a car starts from the rest. Okay. Starts from the rest means initially car having the velocity 0. So at T is equal to 0. We have the V0 as a 0 meter per second. Okay, so you can use this condition. So V10, this value is, this is 0 plus from 0 to 10 second, we have the area. So this is the area. So it is a rectangle. So it is 10 by 10. So V10 is 100 meter per second. Okay. Now we want to find out the T time. Vt is known. So we will write the equation as Vt as a final time, that is equal to its initial velocity will be V10 plus area under the AT diagram from time 10 second to T second. We don't know what is the value of T. We will find out by using this equation. Okay. So Vt, this value is known, that is equal to 0, because finally car is at rest position. So Vt is equal to V10 plus this area from 10 second to T second. So Vt is 0. V10 is just, we have calculated as 100 plus. Now this area is, we have to consider this area. Okay. So this base or this side of that rectangle, so this is equal to T minus 10. Okay. And its height is, this is minus 2 on the negative side. So we will write here T minus 10 into minus 2. Okay. Or you can consider this as a positive and you can take this complete area as a negative. So this is equal to 100 minus 2 into T minus 10, that is equal to 0. So you can rearrange the term. So we will get 2T minus 20 plus 20. Minus 20, this is equal to 100, and T is equal to 60 seconds. Okay, so this is the final time when car will be again at the rest condition. And now find out the position time graph. So to find out the position time graph from the acceleration time, so use this equation, x final is equal to xi plus vi into t plus the area under AT diagram from time ti to tf into t minus tg. Okay, so this is area moment method. So find out the tg value, find out t value. So first select xi, this value is nothing but the x0 value. Okay, so as the car starts from the rest, we will take the x0, that is the initial position, as a 0 meter when time t is equal to 0. Okay, then x final, so select the first 10 second so this is t is equal to 10 second. Then for this, t is equal to 10 minus 0, that is equal to 10. Now for 0 to 10, this is the area. So for this area, we will have the centroid at this position. So this is the G1. So measure the distance with respect to initial time. So this is equal to, total is 10, so this is equal to 5. So Tg, this is equal to 5. So we can write x final means x10 is equal to x0 plus v0 into t plus this area into t minus tg. So x0 is 0, v0 value, this is 0, plus that area is 10 into 10 and t minus tg. So t value, this is equal to 10 minus tg is 5. Okay, so from this we will get the x10 is equal to 500 meter. Okay, then select x60. So x60 is equal to x10 plus v10 into t plus this area from last is 60. So 10 to 60 into t minus tg. So x10, this is 500 plus v10, so refer the velocity. So v10 is 100 meter per second. And this t value, so t here, it is 60 minus 10, that is equal to 50. Plus that area, so here area is negative, so it is minus 50 into 2, and that t minus tg, so it is 50 minus, so this is the area, this is the centroid. Measure the distance with respect to initial time, so this will be, this total is 50, so this will be 25. So this is 50 minus 25. So your final answer . So this is 3000 meter. Okay, and then plot the x3 diagram. So I will draw both the diagrams simultaneously, velocity time and position time. So for velocity time, initial velocity is 0. Then this is 10 seconds and last we have 60 seconds. So at 10 seconds, we have the velocity that is equal to 100 meter per second. And again, at this point, velocity becomes 0. So these are the three points. Now refer the acceleration time diagram. Okay. In the acceleration time diagram, we have the constant acceleration. That means velocity will be straight line. Okay. And again, this is a constant acceleration. But on the negative side, that means velocity is decreasing, having the negative slope. Okay, because your acceleration diagram is like this. This is positive acceleration up to 10 seconds. Then after 10 seconds, we have the negative acceleration. So this is 0 degree curve. So if the acceleration time is 0 degree curve, velocity time will be first degree curve. So this is the first degree curve. Okay. And then position time diagram, it will be second degree curve. That means parabola. So initial position is 0. At 10, we have the position that is equal to 500. So somewhere here. And at 60, we have the position that is equal to 3000. So this is the 3000. Okay. So this is parabola, that is second degree curve, but observe the line. Okay. So here slope of this line is positive. So parabola will be open towards the positive y direction. So this is the parabola. And this parabola is, this is having negative slope. So parabola is open towards the negative y direction. So this is inverted parabola. So this is like this. Okay. So this is how you can draw the velocity time and the position time diagram from the given acceleration time graph.